Satan, have you considered my servant Joe? There's no one on the planet like him. He's a good man. He's blameless, God-fearing, and he despises evil.
Well, of course he is. You've given him a fortune, great health, and a privileged life. But I bet if you took all those things away from him, he will curse you to your face.
Very well, Zin. He's in your hands. Do whatever you please to his possessions and to his family. But do not lay one finger on him. Not one finger. Are we clear?
Oh, Crystal. He will not suffer so much as a paper cut.
Thank you.
All honor and glory be to God. I can't begin to tell you how blessed I feel to stand here and receive this honor. You know, for me, this all started when I was just a boy.
Hey, just got blessed confirmation. It's all downhill from here. Congratulations. Shh.
And then along came Mae Harrison. Mama May. For those of you who had the privilege of knowing and working with her, you know what a force of love she was. The Harrison Home for Boys is born out of that love.
All right.
And built on the foundation of May Harrison.
Where's your brother?
Oh, you know Jason. He is always fashionably late to these things.
No, he's always unfashionably absent.
Now, you know, if it were one of us, it would be a cardinal.
Spotless. From the world. I have been very, very blessed. And I'm so thankful to each of you for this honor. Thank you. Thank you so much, Linda. Thanks, guys. Well, we're 100% full in our housing development.
What about this new live-work community you've got in the works, Midtown Mills? That's a different direction for Patterson, isn't it?
Yes. Well, Midtown Mills is my son's baby. He's worked hard and long to bring this project into fruition, and I could not be more proud of him. Aaron, son, come on. He's a chip off the old block. This is Aaron, people. There he is. Good. Good. Well, all right, listen, if you guys got everything you need, I'd like to get some family photos. Colleen, honey? Abby? Come on, babe. There you go.
Congratulations.
Good. All right, here we go.
Patterson on three.
One, two, three.
Patterson!
How about another slice of pie?
Oh, come on.
Come on, Mr. Lance. Now is not the time for you to start worrying about that waistline.
No, Miss Bailey. I think three slices is quite enough.
Well, I appreciate you guys stopping by. It's always good to have a little briefing before a busy work week.
Absolutely, but we didn't get to talk about Midtown Mills. With the investors coming in tomorrow, I was thinking good time to pull Aaron in.
Aaron has been eating, sleeping, and breathing this project for months. Trust me. He's ready.
Yeah, I believe that, but it wouldn't hurt.
You'll be fine, Lance. I want you guys to stay focused on expanding the low-income housing project. Gary, make sure you check out that site.
I'm all over it, Joe.
Excuse me, Daddy. Sorry. We're leaving now.
Gentlemen, I'll see you tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
But I still don't see what you can do at Jason's you can't do here.
Have fun.
Daddy, we're just going over to watch movies and hang out. You know, sibling bonding.
Oh, yeah. And then after that, we're going to go to the strip club.
We won't stay out too late, Dad.
Phoebe, will you quit playing that morbid song and come on already?
Hey.
Oops. I forgot. Dad, that's your favorite song. My bad.
Aaron.
Yes, sir.
You think it's a good idea for Chelsea to be going out like this?
Pregnant girls go to the strip club.
Oh, I'll be fine.
So will your grandson.
All right, I'll meet you guys later. I gotta go to the Homeless Coalition and have a quick meeting.
A Homeless Coalition? You didn't tell me you took that job there.
Oh, I thought Mom told you.
Son, I told you how these big charities work. They're corporations. The people at the top make all the money and the folks they're supposed to serve.
Yeah, but the coalition isn't like that, Dad. And besides, you know me. I'll keep them honest. I mean, I am Joe Patterson's son, after all, right? Which reminds me, they asked if you could come speak at the luncheon next week. Think you can do it?
We'll see.
Alone, Jason. Can't you see she's practicing for Carnegie Hall? Ladies and gentlemen, Phoebe Patterson playing Moonlight Sonata over and over and over again.
I'm here.
Oh,
bye,
Daddy.
Bye,
baby. Stay out too.
Yes, let's go. Can we go?
Bye. Love y'all.
All right, love you too.
Well, how about some pie? Hey, Miss Bailey, any of that pie left?
And Heavenly Father, watch over them the way you watched over me. And bless them, Father, with wisdom and discernment. And give them the strength to remain righteous in this world filled with evil. In your name, I pray. Abby?
Dr. Forrest, dial 118, please. Dr. Forrest, please dial 118.
Joe, this is just too soon for a baby to be born. I mean, what if it has brain damage or respiratory problems? Look, we gotta do something, honey. We gotta call a specialist.
Please, honey, I know this is scary, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. I mean, we could be worrying for nothing. Abby was premature, remember? And I think we can all agree she turned out just fine. Besides, I don't know that there's time to wait for a specialist.
You're right, Dad. There isn't. They're doing an emergency C-section. My son's gonna be born tonight.
Finish this when I get back.
I gotta make this happen, especially now.
Lance, Daddy wants to see us in his office before the meeting. What are you doing here? Shouldn't you be at the hospital?
I'll see you two inside. I'm going as soon as I close this deal.
Are you serious?
Listen, did you double check the projections?
Yeah, I always do.
Okay, what about the investors? Everybody vetted?
Yes, Aaron, top to bottom.
And the soil test?
Okay, now that's not my job.
I know, but did you at least authorize the testing? Look, Phoebe, I need you.
We can talk about this later. Go be with your son.
Hey. Aaron.
Hey.
Hey, how you doing, son? How's little Aaron? You check on him yet?
I am going to the hospital right after we meet with the investors.
Well, there won't be any investors today. Call off the meeting. I'm sorry I didn't get a chance.
Wait, what? Why?
You're in no condition to deal with this right now, son.
Joe, I can run point on this until little Aaron turns the corner.
I appreciate that, Lance, but the timing is just...
Dad, I'm fine, okay? I can close this.
Son, right now, your place is with your wife and your son. I can explain to investors...
I do not believe this. Why would you cancel my meeting without consulting me first?
The last I checked, I was president of this company, Aaron. Son, Chelsea and little Aaron, they need you right now. Okay? Okay. Lance, let's push Midtown Mills to the back burner for now. Let's move the housing development up on the schedule.
Well, what about the condos? That could be perceived
no,
as...
No, no, no. Housing development first, then the community center. Right now, I'm going to go check on my grandson. Aaron? You coming?
Some juice, sweetie. There you go. How you doing? Good. Get all those off for me, okay? Yeah.
Don't tell me. Another meeting at the Homeless Coalition.
Yep. I figured I'd get down there pretty early today. With all the staff and volunteers we got coming through, those meetings fill up pretty fast.
Mm. Shall I tell them now?
Mm-hmm. Tell me what?
Silas? Son. I want you to be the new director of Harrison Homes.
Wow. What about Ethan?
I'm sending Ethan to college this fall. Once he gets his degree, we'll see where God wants me to put him. But right now, I need someone reliable running things down there. And I know this sort of thing is up your alley.
Yeah, but Dad, I already have a job at the Homeless Coalition. I mean, I can't just quit.
Silas, I'm sure there's a waiting list of applicants just dying to work for a big outfit like that.
Yeah, but Dad, I'll...
Son, I thought you'd be excited.
No, I am excited. Honey, I just...
Honey, this would be such a great opportunity for you to, you know, work with your dad.
I guess I could do both. Scale back part-time until they find someone new.
There you go. You can do both. For now. So, we got a deal?
Deal.
Hey, go. All right.
All right.
All right, sir.
All right. Bye, sweetie.
Yeah.
Yeah. That'd be good for him.
Oh, yeah.
Are you serious? You want to move? Why? Why would we move?
Why not, Aaron? Your father thinks he owns you.
Chelsea.
You work for 6 months on a project, and then he just comes and he snatches it away from you. From us. And he knows he can do it because he knows you depend on him.
No.
So he feels he can do whatever he wants.
No, it's not like that.
Then how is it? Do you want us to depend on him for the rest of our lives? Come on, don't you have your own dreams? Be your own man. If you don't break free from your father now, you never will. And you will always be subject to his whims and his crazy notions about what God has told him to do and what he thinks is best for us. You have to do this for us.
Okay.
I appreciate you coming to Bible study with me. I really do. I can't wait for you to meet the boys. Your mother dropped Abby off earlier. You know, she comes every week. Amazing girl. She's always so helpful. I just wish she'd ever get a license to stop using the rest of us as her chauffeur.
Hey. I was the same way when I came in. 15 years old and a hot mess. I mean, anything and everything possible. You name it, I did it. My parents gave up on me. Nobody knew what to do with me. That's when I met Joe Patterson. I mean, the man took me under his wing, paid it forward, and I've been here ever since.
Hey, guys. I'm glad you're here. You want to know how I turned my life around? I let go. I let go, and I let God. You want to know what that means? It means I handed him the controller to my life. You see what I'm saying? I accepted his friend request, and I log in every day to see what he posts on my wall. Wait. I follow him. Okay. Whenever I have a little tweet, he tweets me.
Listen, that, I gotta tell you, I wasn't too crazy about working here, but I can see how much this place means to you, so.
You sure? I mean, you sure you wanna do this?
I just wanna make you happy. I wanna make you proud.
I'm already proud, son.
It's all good, Dad. It's cool.
Okay. Good.
Yo, Ethan, my man. You want to give me that $5 tour?
My pleasure, brother.
Dad, this is so exciting. I can't wait until I go to college.
And law school?
I want to represent Harrison Home, too, okay? Not just Patterson Development.
Are you guys going to be a while? I'm going to run out of here. By the house. I'll come back and pick Silas up in a couple hours. Okay?
Oh, okay. Cool. Yeah. Night, Abby.
We didn't have a deal. No papers were signed. He wanted to sue me on what grounds?
We did have a verbal agreement.
Gary, this is the 21st century. People sign contracts. Deals are sealed by legally binding documents. Not just a handshake and a slap on their back.
Joe, we've been friends a long time. I think I know you as well as anyone in your family.
You are family, Lance. You're like a brother to me. I know that.
I also know how you are about protecting your family, but I think you're underestimating Aaron and me. Now, I'm more than willing to close the deal with the investors, get the ball rolling on this project.
I appreciate that, Lance. But these guys are blowing smoke.
Joe.
Now, my position stands. We wait.
What'd he say?
He said, tell your wife not to worry so much.
But can you blame me? Lawsuits are expensive. And what if we have to settle? And let's not forget that we're coming out of our own pockets to pay for the Harrison Home expansion.
Are you worried about money, Colleen?
Well, no, but look, we have a family to provide for, including a sick grandchild. There's a lot of people depending on us, Joe.
Well, God will provide. He always has. I don't worry about people's threats.
You know something? When I first met you, you didn't have two nickels to rub together. You were just this skinny, wide-eyed kid who was too stubborn to take no for an answer. You thought you could move mountains. But I believed in you so much that I left my job and invested what little money I had to help you start your own company. One little two-bedroom house at a time.
But
somewhere along the way, you stopped asking my advice. Joe, you stopped needing me.
That's not true, Colleen.
I missed that guy.
Well, that guy wasn't very smart. He had it all wrong.
Maybe, honey, but you don't have to have it all right all the time. It's okay to just be human.
Y'all go ahead and get in the van, all right? I'll be right there in a minute.
All right, fellas. And y'all have fun at the movies, man, and be safe.
Well, welcome aboard, brother. It's always good to have another soldier on the battlefield for Christ, right?
Amen to that, brother. Amen.
I see you, man.
All right, man. All right. Trying to change your life. I got an answer to your question. Thank you, Jesus. God can make it right. He can do it. Don't give up. Just believe in what God has for you. There's a better life. So come get right. Jesus. Hey, welcome to my Harrison home, man. I'm Silas, the new director. What's your name, man?
KJ. Name's KJ.
Cool. You know what we do here, KJ?
Nah. I saw those dudes leave in the van. Do they all live here?
Yeah, until they can get on their feet. You need a place to stay, man? Look, don't worry about that right now. Let me get you something to eat and we can talk about it, all right? Cool. So let me make a quick call real quick. Give me 1 second. Come on, man. KJ, listen to me, man.
Shut up! What are you talking about?
KJ, listen, I know it can get rough sometimes, but God has a plan for your life.
Shut up! Ain't coming for no sermon, man. What is you talking about? Come up off that watch. And that cell phone. And your wallet. Put your wallet in the bag. Move, man! Hurry up. Put this laptop in the bag.
AJ.
Hurry up! Playing with you? Zip it up.
No. Aaron, listen, son, I didn't expect you and your family to live with us forever, but why now? Son, moving is stressful. And if...
Dad, we just need to do this.
Well, I know, but...
KJ, come on, man.
Talk to me like you know me, man. All right, back up. Back up, influence. Yeah.
Silas! Call an ambulance! Silas! I'm right here, son. I'm right here.
Okay?
It's gonna be all right. You know, God is gonna take care of you. God's gonna take care of you just like he's always taking care of you. Okay? Son, you're gonna be just fine.
Silas, all right.
No, don't be sorry. We are going to do so much good in this community. Just you and me, son. You and me, okay? Okay? Just hold on, son.
Look.
Son, I love you. Baby, I love you so, so, so much. And son, I promise God, it's... Yeah. Silas, hold on, the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
I just got off the phone. They found the shooter. A local kid. Grew up in the area.
So much for saving the boys in your own neighborhood. We couldn't even save our own son.
You know, honey, I was thinking, what if we speed up the expansion project? You know, build more homes for these kids, and maybe...
Oh, no. You want to continue this crusade to save those soulless degenerates? Then you do it on your own, but you will not throw away my children's future.
Clay, you're worried about our children who have everything. Who's worried about those boys at that home? I was one of them, remember? No, baby, we owe this to Silas.
Oh, so now you want to acknowledge Silas? Now he matters?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the way you made Silas feel. Like he wasn't good enough. Nothing he did was good enough.
That's ridiculous. Silas was...
All he wanted was to be like you. To be respected by you. Everything he did it for you, Joe. Everything. And now he's gone. My baby is gone, and it's all because
of me.
You know, I thought that working for you would be good for him, good for you. But I guess God had other plans.
I'm not shutting down the home. No. Silas never turned his back on anybody, and neither will I. Keeping it open.
No, with my money, you're not.
When did we get this?
A couple of days ago.
Why was I not informed?
Well, your plate was pretty full with Silas and all. I didn't want to burden you with it until I knew this thing had legs.
How many?
35 of the 60 homes. At least one person in every family suffered some type of respiratory problem. And they believe there was some form of contamination before we built on the site. Maybe a spill.
We tested the land. We followed procedure. This makes no sense.
No, it gets worse. A little boy is in the hospital. An elderly woman died last week. That's what's got everyone up in arms.
How could this happen?
It could stem from the community gardens they started for the co-op. It could be surface water. We've got guys looking into it.
And either way, it looks bad for you. Well, for Patterson.
How could we be allowed to build on contaminated land?
Now, you know how it is, Joe. Sometimes people just, look the other way.
Oh, I didn't know you were busy. I can,
So, the media's gonna be all over this. They're gonna say you cut corners because the housing was for low-income families.
You know, I never cut corners, Lance. We followed the exact same procedure we follow on every other property. Didn't we?
Of course. This is just, I don't know, some kind of fluke.
We built these homes to help people. This was supposed to be a community they could be proud of.
I need to talk to the families.
What's that?
I need to see what we can do to help.
I know you feel bad about this, Joe. We all do. That's not a good idea. There is legal action pending. Let's let the lawyers handle it. Let the attorneys handle it. We settle it nice and quietly.
This isn't just about the money, Lance. I just buried my son. You think I want to see another parent cry over a dead child?
Joe, I know this is hard, especially if with everything... Lance is right. We get the wrong judge, these families walk away with millions. It's bye-bye Patterson Development.
All right, Gary. Round up the legal team.
Get Jeremy in the conference room.
Don't let him make you feel bad for doing what's best for our family.
It's not that, Chelsea. I got a lot on my mind right now.
Look, you've never lived away from your parents before. I get it. And they're not very happy right now, but they'll come around.
They'll come around?
You know, I've always wondered about you and your siblings. With the exception of Jason, you guys have always lived under your dad's thumb.
Okay, I wouldn't put it that way, Chelsea.
No?
All right? No, I would not, because my dad, he's a great dad, all right? Number one, and number two, he's a smart businessman. Why would I go work for some stranger when my dad, he's the guy that everybody else wants to work for?
Everybody?
Yeah, everybody.
Well, Jason's a construction worker. He doesn't work for your dad or live with your dad.
Oh, well, Jason, he's, you know, he's different.
Exactly.
And who knows? I mean, one day, maybe he'll come around, too.
I certainly hope not.
Look, man, you got something you want to say, or you're just gonna stare at me all day. How'd you even get in here anyway? You must have got some pull or something. What, man? What you want?
What happened to you, KJ? What caused you to turn away from God?
Come on, man.
You walk into a space that was supposed to be a safe haven, a place for boys just like you. You gunned my son down in cold blood. And for what? A laptop? And a handful of trinkets. And now you want to stand in here all tough, like you don't care. Acting like my pain doesn't matter. Well, it matters, KJ. My son, he mattered. So whether you like it or not, you're gonna sit your narrow behind down and you're gonna listen to what I have to say. Sit down! You want to know what I see every night when I close my eyes?
my son, laying in his own blood, gasping for life. I can't erase that picture from my mind. And I can't stop blaming myself for what happened to him. That kind of pain. It's hard to live with, KJ. It's gonna be hard for you too. Unless you turn your life around.
Turn my life around? I'm about to go to prison. Probably for the rest of my life for killing your little punk ass son. How am I turn my life around?
I can't say what'll happen in court. But what I can do is I can pray for you. And I can forgive you.
Man, you gotta be kidding me, man.
What, you don't think it's possible?
I don't think it's normal.
Matthew 6:14.
Man, come on, man.
If you forgive men who sin against you.
Forgive me? You gonna forgive me? A second ago, you looked like you wanted to crack my skull in. Now you gonna get all religious and talk about forgiveness. I killed your son! How you forgive somebody for that?
I never said it was easy.
Lance, I don't know if I can make it.
It's gonna be all right. You're gonna get through it.
No.
Ah, Miss Bailey. You're master at making bittersweet.
She's the best. Thank you, Miss Bailey.
And, you know.
So difficult.
Yes, but. Joe,
where have you been? Phoebe said you left the office hours ago.
I assumed you were home, so I just stopped by.
I was at the jail talking to that young man who killed Silas.
You were where?
What's up, Lance?
Three more families joined the lawsuit. The little boy who was in the hospital.
Was.
I'm sorry, Joe.
I need to talk to the mother.
I don't think that's a good idea.
We'll make a contribution to the family, cover funeral expenses.
That'll be viewed as an admission of guilt.
That'll be perceived as a human being helping another human being.
Joe, listen. I think we should settle this thing before it really gets out of hand.
Joe, listen to Lance. He's right.
You know, it looks like you've had a tough day. Tell you what, why don't you two discuss it? Let me know what you decide. Kelly?
Joe, look. You gotta face the reality. Joe!
Hey. Son.
Son.
Yeah. good. So, how's the new place?
Everything's fine.
Good. Listen, Aaron, you really don't have to be here right now. I mean, why don't you take the day?
Just... And do what? Sit around, pray for a miracle? Wallow in the fact that I am completely helpless to do anything for my son? I mean, because after all, I mean, this too is God's will, isn't it? I think I'd rather be here, working, making myself useful.
If you'll let me.
And like I was saying, I managed to get the Midtown Mills investors to back off.
Really?
Yeah.
And how'd you do that?
Long story, but I'm afraid we won't be so lucky with the contamination case. More families have signed on to the lawsuit, and now a judge has... issued an order freezing our assets.
We've appealed to him to reconsider, but in light of the two deaths...
Deaths? What deaths?
Our legal team is trying to protect your personal assets, Joe, but I've tried to advise you not to use personal money to subsidize your business ventures, and now it's at risk. I mean, it's all at risk.
So it's been determined that all of this is due to soil contamination?
Yeah, the tests are pretty conclusive.
So I guess we just have to settle.
Our lawyers have already been talking, but their asking price is pretty steep.
Steep? They want to bleed us dry.
Well, be a lot worse if they won in court. Plus, our reputation would be ruined.
True. Lance, I want an internal investigation into this entire matter. I want to know who dropped the ball.
Yeah.
Okay, so I guess that's it. We settle the lawsuit, get the courts to unfreeze our assets, and let's get back to work. In the meantime, I'm going to talk to the families.
Joe.
Dad, you can't.
Joe, please don't do that.
We heard you've been talking to all the families.
Yes.
And if you're here to try to lowball us.
No. I'm here because I want you to understand that I understand what you're going through.
Do you, Mr. Patterson? Have you ever lost a child?
As a matter of fact, I have. My younger son, Silas, was killed recently. My family's in pain, just like yours.
Our family, we'd really like to help. Silas would have wanted that.
You see, this lawsuit pretty much destroyed everything that my family's worked so hard to build.
You should have thought about that before building houses on old dump sites.
It was a terrible, terrible oversight. And I agree.
You say you lost a child, Mr. Patterson.
Yes.
How many do you have left?
Four.
Good for you. I got none. My only son is dead due to your oversight.
I'm so sorry.
Get the hell away from my house.
Get the hell away from my house!
It's okay.
I think you need to leave, Mr. Patterson. And we're not taking a penny less than what we asked for. Maybe next time you'll show more regard for the people you claim to care so much about.
Dad, come on, let's go.
So we're broke.
Well, the families wouldn't budge. And the settlement is huge. So we're in a tight spot.
Tight spot? I don't understand. What does that mean?
We no money. Zero.
No money? This doesn't make any sense.
Look. The truth is, we're being tried.
Seems to be a lot of that lately.
This isn't funny, Jason.
Well, I never said that it was. I just don't see why everybody is freaking out.
We're freaking out because we're on the verge of losing everything.
Everything, Phoebe? We are just on the verge of losing money.
Look, I know you don't care about our family business.
I care about our family.
But all of us. Most of us have worked hard for what we have.
Then I guess we'll have to work just as hard to keep it or to get it back.
You just think everything is so easy.
I do believe it's that easy, Phoebe. I believe it's that. No, it is that easy.
Okay,
all right, everybody. All right.
All right. Listen, now the last thing we need to do is turn on each other. We're going to weather this storm.
Yeah, right. With God's help. Chelsea, let's go. We have to get back to the hospital.
I gotta go too. Since I might be the only one in this family with a J-O-B, I better go home and get some sleep.
Hey.
Don't worry, Daddy. Oh. Everything's gonna be okay.
I know. Hey. You've always been my rock. You're not gonna let a little lawsuit shake you up, are you?
It's not just a lawsuit, Dad. People are sick. People are dying.
I know. And we're gonna help them.
Help them do what? Bring their loved ones back? Make their children better?
Look, sweetheart, it's...
No, it's all my fault.
No.
It's all my fault. We thought everything would be fine. It's happening so fast, there wasn't enough time, and you had a deadline.
Phoebe, what are you talking about?
I never wanted this. I never wanted any of this. I tried to tell you I couldn't do all this stuff. I tried to tell you.
Are you telling me the evaluations on that land was never done?
They were done. The remediation wasn't.
Ah.
There was so much pressure to meet deadlines. And by the time we found out that the remediation hadn't been done, construction had already started. It would help me dodge the bullet. But...
Phoebe, it's okay. It's all right.
No. It's not okay.
It's...
What if more...
Listen to me. Not a word. Not a word about this. Do you understand me? Not a word to anyone. Okay? Phoebe, honey, wake up. Phoebe! Colleen! Colleen! Phoebe,
wake up. For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God, it is wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our deceased sister. We therefore commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Come on, God. He's lost his fortune, two of his beloved offspring, and now everyone is going to turn their backs on him. And when they do, he will definitely turn his back on you.
Are you sure about that?
I bet his life on it.
You'll see.
This all started.
I was so mean to her. She hated me.
She did not hate you. Phoebe loved you. She loved all of us.
Well, she thought I hated her. She thought we all did, right? I mean, that's why she...
Abby, stop it. All right? I think there was something going on with Phoebe that we just didn't know about. Something was weighing on her. I could tell.
I should have pressed her. I should have made her talk
to me. It's not your fault, Aaron. Or yours, Abby.
It's mine. If anyone is to blame for what happened to Phoebe and Silas, it's me.
Dad, what are you...
I put too much pressure on them. On all of you. I'm sorry. I can only pray that God will forgive me.
Joe, did you hear me? The judge approved the settlement.
Good.
Joe, do you realize what this means? It's all gone.
I understand, Gary.
I'm saying you've lost everything. Everything.
Then we'll start over. We'll build everything up again, brick by brick. Those who want to stay can stay. Those who want to leave can leave. With God's help, we will rebuild it all.
What's gonna happen to us?
Well, I guess we just gonna have to figure it out.
With what? I mean, by the time these people are done with us, all we're gonna have is the clothes on our backs.
Well, we started out with the clothes on our backs clean. God bless us.
Oh, is this what you call a blessing? You know, all you do is pray and pray, and this is the blessing that you get from God. Well, please forgive me for not falling to my knees and giving thanks for this wonderful blessing, because all I see around me is pain and suffering and death. Where's the blessing, Joe?
I didn't hear you complaining before. What? Baby, are we just supposed to accept the good and not the bad? Honey, sweetheart. I'm doing everything I can to hold this family together, and I need you to trust me. I need you to help me, Colleen.
Isn't that what you have God for?
I don't think he realizes how tough this is for you.
Joe was just being Joe, praying, trying to fix everything, and trusting that God would help us.
And you don't believe that?
I just want my life back, Lance.
You know, I think Joe has always felt that you and I... it's tough being the best friend of a guy who leads a charmed life.
Charmed life. Really?
I'm sorry. That's not what I meant.
I know what you meant.
But you have to admit he's had some lucky breaks. Always got everything he wanted. It could be important.
Hello?
Joe! Joe! Where's Jason? What happened?
Well, the doctor will be out in a minute.
What's the doctor saying?
Look, all I know is he was involved in a head-on collision. A woman was driving his car, one of his girlfriends, I guess, but she didn't make it.
What is the doctor saying about Jason? I mean, is he going...
Mr. Patterson? Jason has sustained severe injury to his spinal cord. It's too early to say whether the damage will be permanent, but you should be prepared.
But he's alive.
Yes, he's alive.
Is he going to be paralyzed?
That's a possibility.
Can we see him?
He's asleep, give him some time. He's pretty banged up, but it could have been a lot worse.
Mom, I'm so sorry. I just got your message.
Sweetie, it's okay. It's okay. Look, Jason has been injured, but thank goodness he's going to pull through.
Hi, we came to your house, but...
It's okay. I appreciate you coming by, but my son, he's going to be okay.
Any news on Abby?
Oh, you know what? I forgot to call her. She said she was going to the mall with some friends.
Mom, she called me to come and get her, Mom, but I was here with little Aaron, so she called Jason. Abby was with Jason.
Where is she? The young lady in the car with my son. She's my daughter. Where is she?
Oh, my God.
Where is she? With the girl who was in the car with my son. Where is she? Come on, God. Where is she? Not Bobby. Colleen, listen to me.
No,
listen
it's too
to me,
late.
Honey.
No,
you're not
Joe.
Thinking. Colleen,
no, Joe.
Listen.
Joe,
Colleen.
I can't take it anymore.
You're not thinking straight. Listen, you just need to get help. This is what's talking.
There's nothing wrong with me. It's all about you.
No,
you...
baby. Honey. Honey. Colleen.
Bye.
Colleen.
Any man will give all that he has for his own life. Take away his health, and he will surely curse you to your face.
Very well, Satan. Have your way with Joe. But you are not allowed to take his life.
What are you, watching your weight?
Gotta keep my fighting weight up.
Yeah.
Allergies. Listen, I was thinking of starting small. Single-family houses or townhomes and working my way up to the commercial stuff, you know. That's how we did it when we first started, remember? I got a complete business plan. I can,
Joe, I think I speak for Jeff when I say that we like you.
Mm-hmm. We do, Joe. Mm-hmm.
But after all those lawsuits...
No. They've all been settled. Handsomely. Cost me my shirt, my socks, my company.
I'm sorry, Joe. We just can't run the risk of...
being associated.
I'm sorry. It's declined.
Please, take that.
Well, thanks.
Joe, I'd really like to help you out, but
Then do it. Help me, Wayne. I was one of your biggest depositors for over 10 years.
I know, but I can't. It's just too risky. You've already defaulted on the loan for the boys' home.
I can catch up on the loan. I just, I need to rebuild my business. It won't take long.
Joe, I can't. We're having to be a lot more careful these days. Joe, are you all right? You want some more water?
No, I'm fine. I must be coming down with a bug or something.
Are you sure? I can call Aaron or Colleen.
No, I'm fine. I'm fine. Thanks. Thanks for your consideration, Wayne.
Son, come on in.
You know, I actually got to get going.
Okay. Is everything all right?
Look, I'm going to get straight to the point.
Okay.
I've revived the Midtown Mills project. I have investors on board. We're ready to roll.
I assume these are the same investors from before. And Wait. Don't tell me. They're willing to fund the project as long as I'm not involved. Well, that all makes sense. Why they backed off. We're just waiting in the cut.
I was hoping you'd be happy for me.
That you're taking money from greedy, selfish men who only care about lining their own pockets. Oh, yeah, that makes me very happy. Congratulations.
You've never supported this project. It wasn't your idea, so you never wanted it to succeed.
No, it's not the project, Aaron. Son, it's your motivation. You're driven by money and power.
Says the man who had more money and power than half of Atlanta. You really think you were successful because God chose you? You were successful because you used to be a good businessman. You knew how to make money. You knew how to close deals. God had nothing to do with it. Anyone who thinks that God is going to look out for them is a damn fool. You wait on the Lord, Dad. Yeah, you do that. In the meantime, I'm gonna go out there and I'm gonna make things happen on my own.
Son of real estate developer Joe Patterson heads off a new live-work community expansion project called Midtown Mills in the greater Atlanta area. Backed by prominent local investors Harrison Greens and Laurent Matthews.
So it gives me great pleasure to announce today that thanks to the unwavering support of this fine team of investors, Midtown Mills is finally moving forward. I'd like to thank these two gentlemen right here, and we plan to announce the start of construction within the coming weeks.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Doc.
Okay, now, based on these type of lesions, I think I have a pretty good idea as to what this is, but I'm going to run some tests to see if we can get to the bottom of what's causing your symptoms.
Good. What's your best guess?
Could be shingles. Now, you had a physical exam a few months ago, and everything checked out fine. So, has anything changed since then?
It's, a little.
Now, as soon as I get these test results in, I'm going to contact you, okay? All right. Take care.
Okay.
let me in or what?
You really shouldn't be here, son. I can't take care of you.
I don't know if you looked in the mirror lately, Dad, but I'd say you're the one who needs to be taken care of.
Well, you got problems of your own.
What, this? No, this isn't a problem, Dad. This is a new perspective.
You got a pretty sunny disposition for a guy in a wheelchair.
And you got a pretty crappy one for a man of faith.
A man who brought too much suffering on his family.
Mom misses you.
Mother's better off.
What? Without you? And what about you, Pops? You better off without her? Mom lost her faith. She gave up. Looks to me like you're just trying to do the same thing.
You know how much you love Tilly's barbecue. Come on, Joe, we made the trip to the West Side just for you.
I'm just really not hungry.
You know, for as long as I've known you, Joe, you've been a stand-up guy, helping people, going to church, always trying to do the right thing. But I got to tell you, all this stuff, you know, it's pretty weird. I mean, I'm not a, you know, theological expert, not like you, but it seems to me that if, well, if God allows someone to suffer as much as you've suffered, it must have a reason.
You know, no offense, Joe, but I've been kind of thinking the same thing. Why do you think God's so ticked off with you?
It certainly does appear that God has abandoned me. I'm torn in his wrath, and he hated me. And you believe it's because of something that I've done? You two, you know me better than anyone. You know how I live my life.
I'm true, but we only know what we see, Joe.
The guy upstairs, he sees everything. Right? Maybe he caught a glimpse of you doing something you shouldn't have. I'm just asking.
I don't know what you two think I've done, nor why you believe this is some form of retribution.
Oh, come on, Joe. What else could it be? I mean, why else would good old righteous Joe Patterson suffer like a common sinner?
That's a good question, Lance.
Yeah, it is. How about an answer?
Actually, I'd like one myself.
Hey, you know what? One day you'll get to ask the big guy himself.
You know, Uncle Lance, you guys have a pretty interesting take on all of this, but I think I need to check you on a couple things. You too, Derek. You look back on everything that's happened to my father and my family, and you're 100% sure he's being punished. In fact, you guys seem to kind of like the idea of seeing Mr. Holier-than-thou, Joe Patterson, meet the wrath of a vengeful God. And, Dad, you're wondering, why me? Why is God making me suffer? After all, you are God's prized pupil, and you, Joseph Patterson, have been more righteous than anyone. But are you more righteous than God? Why you, Dad? Why not you? Did it ever occur to you, to any of you, that suffering is a blessing? That it actually has some sort of divine purpose to it? That sometimes the big guy chooses to show us his power through pain? Sounds crazy, doesn't it? Dad, I remember you telling us the story of the blind man. You remember that?
Jesus' disciples saw the blind man, and right away they assumed he was blind because he or his parents were sinners. And Jesus told them nobody had sinned. He said the man was blind so that
the works of God might be displayed in him.
So I guess it just proves, fellas, it ain't always the blind who can't see.
And sometimes we see and we simply choose to look away.
Very nice, Jason. Very nice. Well, I always thought you were the one of all of Joe's children who didn't swallow all those pious lectures he shoved down your throat. Nonetheless, he is not blind Bartimaeus or whoever he is.
No, no. He's not, Uncle Lance. You're right. But he is Job. A righteous man. A loving father. Yeah, maybe a little obsessive. But loving. Honorable and good. A faithful servant who suffers for no apparent reason except for the fact that old Satan just wants him to curse God. A man who lost his wealth, his reputation, his health, and three of his children. My brother and sisters. But my father never lost his faith. Never.
All this time, I thought you weren't listening.
And all these years, I thought you were.
Let's go, Gary. Gary.
Dad, everything that happened to you, to us, it's just a reminder that God's in charge and that we gotta trust in him no matter what. This kind of pain and suffering is to draw us closer to him and to each other.
Yeah.
I mean, everything, the good, the bad, it's all his will.
Yeah.
All day, every day.
Every day.
I love you, Dad.
I love you, son.
Some rest.
Heavenly Father, I come to you broken. Completely surrendered, asking, Father, your forgiveness, and my world is crumbled. But even in my darkest hour, I will trust you and only you, and I will remain your humble and faithful servant. Until the day I die, in your name, Father, I pray. Amen.
Just let it go, let go, let go. Please, just let it go.
Jason, hand me that tape measure. Thanks, son.
Well, look who's here.
Hey.
Hey. I wouldn't blame you if you asked me to leave, but I hope you won't. We built a life with nothing together, Joe. I know we can do it again. I'm so sorry.
Clay. It's okay. I'm glad you're here. I missed you.
I missed you too.
Aaron. Son, who's this?
Dad, this is your grandson.
Yeah, you can hold him. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. Good job.
Well, what do you think?
Look at you.
You look so good.
Thank you.
It's so nice of you to drive your friends around.
As long as I can drive, I'm happy to help.
You don't need to earn a paycheck to work hard. Working together, we'll make sure you spend your retirement the way you want to. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
Move Free Ultra, the smallest joint health pill with a triple action formula for joint, cartilage, and bone. Move on to Move Free Ultra. And now, try new Move Free Night, the first and only 2-in-1 joint and sleep supplement.
Dinner at Golden Corral is now rib-sational. Introducing baby back ribs with KC Masterpiece Barbecue Sauces. Try the original, hickory brown sugar, or smoky chipotle. Unlimited everything, just $11.99. Golden Corral, the best buffet in the USA.
Doers. They don't worry if something's possible. They just do it. At Sears Optical, we're committed to bringing them eyewear that works as hard as they do. Right now, save up to $200 on eyeglasses. Quality eyewear for doers. Sears Optical.
If you have play dates at your house, be ready to clean up the mess.
The kids had fun, but it's pretty gross.
What's that?
It's a Swiffer wet jet. I can just grab this and just go right to the mess.
That comes from my floor?
That's disgusting.
I want friends over.
You want friends over?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. Hey, Dad. You know, Gary introduced me to a new team of investors for the Midtown Mills project.
Listen, good, good.
Yeah, those other guys, they...
I know, sir. I know.
I could use your help.
Aaron, I love you, son.
I love you too, Dad.
Of course you got my help.
Yeah.
Of course.
Well, who's hungry?
Oh, I am. I'll make us some lunch.
No, Miss Bailey.
I'll help.
Thank you.
Wait. First.
Let us bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us all back together again. We have been through so much. Thank you for showing us that we can triumph over it all and that we will come back better than ever as long as we trust in you. In your name, amen.
Amen.
Let me get him.
Don't you get any chicken grease on him or anything like that?
Yeah. Mm. Oh. Take his nose. AJ, take his nose. He likes you.
And the Lord accepted Job's prayer. After Job prayed for his friends, the Lord restored his fortune and gave him twice as much as he had before. The Lord blessed the latter part of Job's life more than the former part.